So he's got a fresh bandana on. Coming off of injury, he lost to Omar Asar earlier in this tournament. That's his only loss that I've seen. So Ma Long to start this best of five. First player to win three games. Here we go. Oh, some big risks right off the bounce. Fearless Timo Boll. I mean, it's only the first point, but it just goes to show you that he's really clear on what he has to play like. Ma Long has been behind many times in this tournament and come back. Still does give a bit of hope after the first point like that, we'll see. Oh, break off the net for Ma Long. These points are so tricky. Timo with a very shallow, spinny shot that left Ma Long with an awkward ball.
It's the shot that Ma Long does here, that one. That's an incredible shot.
Yeah, whenever someone says machine, I mean, record-wise, yes, he's so undefeated for the most part. It's quite rare. But nice through-the-legs catch from Timo there, keeping his swag. But I was going to say, he does have some brilliantly creative shots as well and touch play that are just magical. It's also quite tough to receive. It's not a flashy serve, but it's very subtle, and if Timo has trouble reading it, that says quite a lot. From overhead, you could see it wasn't too deep on the table, but from down low, you can see the height. Just an extra inch, that's enough for Ma Long to destroy the third ball.
That's the problem that Boll has. He has to stop Ma Long getting in with the strong topspins. Similar pattern to the first service in this sequence. There's that forehand topspin, just total body action goes into it. Tremendous amount of power. Just look at that.
And the placement was pretty excellent. I mean, Timo kept it relatively low, deep to the backhand corner, but unless Ma Long is fooled, he's just so quick and agile to get back into position for that shot.
And I think, Adam, one of the other strengths I feel that Ma Long has is sometimes when he is stretching and he is out of position and he isn't that well balanced, he still can generate a lot of power.
Yeah, he never really seems out of the point. Now, one thing that Timo, one of many things that Timo has going for him, but especially in this matchup here, is his spin variety. Yesterday against Korea, against Lee Song-soo, we saw several points where Timo had spinny, awkward backhands with side spin that were missed. He won a good percentage of those points. So back within one here, Boll near the table, getting in early. It's just different every time, I feel like, with Timo. His variety in his game can be one of the most challenging factors to break the rhythm. Ma Long, again, very adaptable to rhythm change, but still, Timo, very tricky.
And that's an example of the pressure that Boll's under. He has to keep it tight. And of course, when you have to keep it tight, then you are likely to make one or two pushing errors. Just so determined to keep that low over the net, it just dropped on the wrong side.
The serve drifts a little bit long. Ma Long gets the opening attack, and immediately Timo Boll's odds go way down. Not by a lot. It's just a little bit tighter. Maybe you get some hesitation from Ma Long, but we rarely see that. I was trying to think of the last time I saw him hesitate on a shot, look confused for a moment about what was happening. Oh, this is a perfect example. Timo actually makes the tough shot here, blocks it to the complete other corner, and magically Ma Long is there ready for a counter to the short side.
Is he going to get it, you're thinking to yourself? Not only does he get it, he plays a rocket down the line. I mean, that sums him up in many aspects.
So second towel break of the game and the match. Ma Long up by 4.
Possibly then just took a little bit of the pace off the ball, went for a little bit more, threw it up. Variation. Timo Boll would have been expecting a rocket.
He'd be right there. I mean, a deep push to the backhand. Ma Long, just like he's ready for anything. When you're in the driver's seat on the serve, still, but he had the right foot forward for that. Still no problem. Looked like a textbook backhand for him, just a walk in the park. And now 6 game points for Ma Long to dominate game number 1. And he takes it 11-4. The dictator dictating game number 1. Captain Long in the lead, and we'll be back for game number 2 right after this.
Well, I think he put a marker down with the first point of the first game, did Timo, when he ran round and played a forehand from the backhand side. And it was almost like, I'm going to go for it here. I'm going to throw caution to the wind. I'm going to gamble. And I think he's just got to do that. But
and this is sort of what we see from injured players who can't afford to get in the rally. Just give me 2 shots and that's it. And he puts in a little extra here. It looked like he really put in more effort than we saw in some of these opportunities from the back of the table in game 1. A little bit more passive receive here from Ma Long. Not a bad length. Would it have come down for a second bounce? Tough to tell from there.
See, and again, when you ask, you know, what can he do? You know, physically, we're not actually sure what Timo can
right.
do. Whether he can... He'll continually run around his backhand and be quick on his feet and get him with the forehand from the backhand side of the table. That's his great shot. You're never sure where it's going. Is it going on the diagonal, down the line, into the body?
Ooh.
But things like that's a good idea. You know, they're doing something a little bit different, trying to take Ma Long by surprise.
Yeah, every shot in this rally, from the touch shot to the follow-up Chiquita there. Yeah, side spin sometimes changes people, and they're not quite so quickly calibrated. Outstanding rally, and the pace coming back from Ma Long. Timo has trouble staying on top of that last ball.
We've talked in previous games, and an expression we've used a few times is slugging it out at the table. You know, I'm not sure that Timo can physically slug it out here with Ma Long.
In terms of winning, it's tough to imagine someone winning against Ma Long right now if they're not quite aggressive. I mean, Robbie Gardoche was at 7-7 in game 4, 2-1, and this is great use. So this quality of a counter, it's a short stroke from Timo on the backhand. It's very efficient, and it's using Ma Long's speed and strength against him. So from here, it was even less compact than I realized. It was actually a bit of a stroke. A little extra spin here, slower shot.
Very good, Ken. Up with the direction of the stroke, as you can see, up, brushing up the topspin rather than the speed.
You know, as we're at the first towel break here, there was a lot of analysis, again, of the Dusseldorf men's singles final between Ma Long and Fan Zhendong, and it was fascinating, just endless reading on that match. But Ma Long was not the first to attack. On average, he was, I'd say Fan Zhendong was the first to open. And I think if Timo can do the same here, meaning if he can let Ma Long have the first opening attack from really just a slightly weaker place, if he can surprise him. I know we've been talking about the exact opposite, not letting Ma Long get the first attack. And I think ideally that would be the case, but anything he can do to surprise Ma Long, just get a slightly weaker one or a more predictable one, like that block on the backhand side, there's still a handful of options. Just none of them are very likely.
I think sometimes in a rally, if you do, you know, a good aggressive long push return of service, inviting your opponent to make the first topspin, and then you make the counter topspin, statistically, you've not opened the rally up. You're not the first one to make the topspin. Because you've done an excellent return of service, right, you've created the opportunity for your follow-up.
Timo's actually talked about how that's a big part of his game now, the counter-attack game in the rally. Wow. Still it took that many. That was the hesitation I was thinking. Timo, if Timo can serve that perfectly half long, look at Ma Long, changes his mind to a push, still gets himself back in the point. Timo's footwork here. Again, every single moment, his feet never rest for more than just a heartbeat. Timo outscoring his score already from game one by 2 points. That's a perfect right angle. They really get the best umpires here. I mean, it's quite formal. I've tried that. Not even close. That was the long push, and it was surprising. It looked like he was going to drop it short to the forehand. Lee Swin, the coach for the women's team, the world champion coach of this year. Look at that. Was watching, just thinking, geez, what do you do? And the combination, that bending angle, bit of side and top, that's the backhand from Timo that has its own highlights video on ITTF's YouTube channel. Richard Prowse there with the German contingency. Good lead for Timo here, but far from safe. Ooh, still almost keeps it in play. It's tough not to hit a shot like that second to last shot Timo hits and expect it to come back. But he does. I think he's, 20 years playing world-class table tennis, you know to never stop the point. Again, just compliments to Ma Long for being able to block that back into play, get back into position. Timo's timing, people often ask, what is it about Timo that makes him competitive with the Chinese and has over the years? His timing is a big part of that. Oh, the angle, that's just amazing. In a rally like this, to find that angle, see if Ma Long makes his way back into the table a little bit. Way out in front. Still, that's such a risky shot to play. This is the perfect angle to see. Well, he holds his ground, doesn't make his way back in at all. The risk was there. Two in a row for Ma Long, just down by one now on the receive.
Again, he's exploited that area wide to Bol's forehand. This time he exploited it early in the rally.
Generally, I feel that this can be effective against left-handed players, especially ones who've been turning the corner, which is quite common. A little surprised here for Timo. Often we'll see him keep that shot in play. Maybe he thought there was a little bit different spin on it and maybe a little bit more side spin to carry it back. Three in a row here for Ma Long. Ooh, even Ma Long needing a little extra time here for the planning. Heavy underspin on the pendulum.
Again, the tactics from Bol there, he's making it difficult for Ma Long to get out wide to his forehand there, but the touch wasn't quite there on the serve.
So back from the timeout, we'll see what Timo Bol has to offer. I mean, if this comes down, if it's a spinny shot, everything has to be right. And Timo's delivered that before, but from the start of the contact, it just doesn't work out for him.
Again, it's the variation from Marlong there. You expect him potentially to flick that, to topspin that, but the long, fast push deep into the ball backhand.
Shot. What feeling. Magic from under the table and the swatting backhand. That's some serious pressure from down low. Watch how close to the net this ball stays. Timo sneaks around the table. Ma Long tries to play a touch shot, does so, but guess who's there? 37-year-old Timo Boll right there waiting. Just rips and destroys that ball. Yeah, I feel you, Ma Long. Sometimes you just have to exhale and get ready for the next point. Still in the lead by one, Ma Long on the receive.
Fire!
That is the most fired chole I've heard. I think that just is a sign of respect for Ma Long, or for Timo Boll, rather, that Ma Long needs this point so badly. He doesn't want Timo getting back in. He knows what it's like to be beaten by Timo recently. And when you're Ma Long right now, you're at the top of your game since 2015 again. Very few have been able to stop Ma Long. This is important. He's got not only the whole team behind him, but the whole country watching right now, waiting for him to deliver for China to take the gold. Two game points for Ma Long on the serve. And the Dragon does it with the scales on his back. Ma Long goes up 2-0, and Timo Boll in some trouble. He's got no timeouts left.
I was just saying, the shot that I thought was inspirational there was the one where Timo returned the net cord, and it was almost as though he hung on to the back at the end of the handle to give himself an extra couple of inches, but still had incredible control.
Yeah, we've seen Timo falling. We've seen Timo from the ground. We've seen him with the hand switch. It's almost like it's just in his blood. He's got a magnet permanently from his DNA for the ball to go back to the table. That being said, he's down 0-2 against Ma Long. You know, the only loss Ma Long has had in the Team World Championships is to this man right here, Timo Boll. Only loss in his career. Team World Championships. That was quite some time ago now. See, that was in 2010 in Moscow. So we'd probably have a timeout here if Timo had one left to give or use.
But I think your analysis was right against Ma Long. It's probably too late now.
You know, I was asked on Liebherr Live, what are the odds here? And there are plenty of positives to highlight, but it really is quite unlikely. Germany would have to pull off essentially a magical upset three times against the best team, arguably, in the history of table tennis. Here we go. This is great angular deflection here, just really getting back in. He's stretched out, and Timo plays this one back, just using his opponent's speed and spin, and Ma Long hung out to dry. The crowd is so involved before that the players had to wait for them to stop. It's always a good sign.
Quite read the spin. I think he thought there was a little bit more backspin on the ball. He came under it, did vault. See here on the replay there. So his finger comes up the top of the blade there.
Yeah.
The back of the blade as he for the returner serve with his forehand. He's very well caught by the camera angle.
Yeah, it is interesting. You know, we see some different grips from different players, but usually not varying that much. Timo has his own style a little bit in terms of technique, but obviously he's done quite well with it. Good setup. Still has to make another high pressure shot off the bounce. Oh, that moment. That kid's career. There's the spinny one, the counter. Good side. Look how close to the table he is here. You know, on certain tables we've seen, he would have kicked the cage coming in like that. Under the table, his foot would have hit. You would have heard a big noise. This is a nice surprise for me on the push. I mean, Timo was in an uncomfortable position, and it looked like he had, it was a net ball right before, and I thought he was gonna go to the backhand. Ma Long getting the racket all the way behind the head for the spin, and still Timo keeps it in play.
Classic example of the long push being used very effectively. Your opponent makes the topspin, but then you come in and counter topspin.
It's interesting to watch two players who have more blades being used by other pros using their own blades. Timo Boll using the Timo Boll, Ma Long using the Ma Long. We got some touch play from Ma Long behind the table, but it gives Timo a chance to get in for some power. Good start to the point here as well. The flip and the top spin from the start. More aggressive, positive receive. Timo come in for that over the table. And the angle of the racket, just so casual. That's really all it takes if you know where the ball is coming, know how to control it, and Timo obviously knows better than most. Good read, a good receive from Ma Long. A lot of people have had trouble with that reverse pendulum serve, and the length seemed quite solid.
Flip the turn, a little bit of top spin. Kept it quite low over the net. Ball ended up lifting a little bit too much. There he goes, off the end of the table. All sorts of variations on the return of serve from Ma Long. The short push, the flick, the long fast push. And you don't know till the last second which one of those options he's going to adopt.
So I just got news, actually, that there were three times that Timo Boll has beaten Ma Long in his career, in the last, at least in the last 10 years. They were listed out, but right now it's looking incredibly unlikely. We will see Ma Long with 7 game and match points over Timo Boll.
Got it!
And the dictator doesn't even have to say it. What's this? He's cradling a baby? Is that what he was doing? I know he's a father, that's right. He's a young father. Maybe daddy does it, daddy dictates.